वेलकम बैक टू माई चैनल फ्रेंड्स, इट्स साइड सोनिया हियर एंड इन टुडेज़ वीडियो वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस एवरीथिंग अबाउट डेकोपाज एंड आई एम सो एक्साइटेड. सो नाउ हियर आई हैव अ कार्डबोर्ड बॉक्स विच आई एम सेलिंग अप विद माई एब्रो टेप. आई एम जस्ट ट्राइंग टू गिव अ लिटिल मोर स्ट्रेंथ टू दिस बॉक्स सो दैट आई कैन हैव माई डेकोपाज टिश्यूज ऑन दिस. नाउ हियर वी आर गोइंग टू अप्लाई जेसो ऑन दिस कंप्लीट बॉक्स फ्रॉम आउटसाइड एंड आई एम यूजिंग अ स्पंज डॉबर. इफ़ यू वॉन्ट यू कैन इवन यूज़ योर ब्रश, paint brushes and the sponge pieces, and they are going to work wonderfully. Now I have prepared some questions so that I can answer you for that. Now my first question is, decoupage can be done on wet surfaces. Now this is something which all of us get confused when we have to start with decoupage. Now my friends, it's very simple. Decoupage can be done on any of the surfaces, like you name it and you can do the decoupage work on that. Be it the plastic, ceramic, wood, MDF, plastic, like even the book covers can be decoupaged, the cardboard, metal, anything and everything can be done decoupage. So why we do decoupage? Decoupage is just an art which helps you in enhancing that product. Like there are many times there is something lying in our house which is of very good use, but we don't like the look and feel of it. So what do we do with that? Do we throw that? No, we can't. So we do this beautiful art form that is decoupage art, and which really, really, really helps in giving a new look and a complete makeover to your space. Now, when we say where we can do decoupage, decoupage can be done when I'm saying wood, that doesn't mean only the furniture, even the doors can be done decoupaged. When we say plastic, it's not only the containers or the jars, even the plates can be done decoupaged. If you go through my channel, you can see varieties of decoupage products what I have created with different suppliers. And yes, of course, I have done this on the tin metal boxes, to plastic containers, to plastic pots, to ceramic pots and whatnot. So definitely when it comes to decoupage, it can be done on any of the surfaces. Now, which paint can be used with decoupage art? And this is so exciting. Like in this video here right now, I'm using an acrylic paint, as you can see. So what can we do with the paints? And you have a long list. Like you can use acrylic paints, metallic paints, shimmer paints, your spray paints, watercolor and whatnot. Now talking about this video here, I have used a black color acrylic paint and I'm just splashing some of the dots on the sides of my boxes. Now this is what I have planned and this is how I wanted to work on this video. When we talk about the colors, it's not that every time you have to just take up your paintbrush and paint it. You can just use them with the splash, you can do some kind of watercoloring to it. And each and every form of art looks beautiful when you experiment with your supplies, when you experiment with the colors, and they are going to look absolutely gorgeous. Now in this video, like I wanted to create something to keep my decoupage napkin collection. I already have an MDF box, but then that one is already filled up. I wanted another one and I did not want to buy something new. This was a cake box which was lying at my place for almost like 4 months now. And I thought of giving a makeover to it so that it looks beautiful and it looks much more tempting when I'm doing my work. Here, if we have to talk about the tools what we can use, you can use paint brushes, you can use palette knives, you can use your sponge dauber, and all these supplies are so great when we say that we need something really good to paint our object. You don't have to take up the brush and just brush it up with the regular paints. No, there are so many exciting, really, really enhancing ways of creating any of your beautiful piece of art. Do try this, friends, and this is going to work really well and you are going to enjoy this for sure. Now here I'm using my heat gun to speed up the drying process of my project. The next question what I have is, what are the varieties of paper we can use for decoupage? I have already done a live session on this, and like as I am showing in this video, I am using a decoupage napkin for this and I'm going to remove the plies once I'm done with the cutting work and then I will stick this. Now, what are the papers we can use? We can use decoupage napkins, as you have seen in this video. Then if you check my other videos, you must be seeing that I have used pattern papers also. I have also shown using the rice paper. You can even try doing the decoupage work with the newspaper what comes to your place every day. You can even do with any of your magazine cutouts. You can even do the decoupage work with any of your comic books or the magazine on an old book, and they are going to look absolutely fab. Gift wrapping paper are also one of the very, very, very good option when it comes to decoupage. Yes, I have to make a video on that, and I will be sharing that video really soon. I've been already working on that, but it's taking a little more time for me to edit the videos and upload it, and just because it's a lockdown time, it takes a little more time to work because everyone is around the house. Now, when we speak about the decoupage papers, there are many brands, those who come with decoupage papers. Each brand has their own quality, own beautiful designs, or like their own good feel factor of it. So I would really recommend you to try the various brands what is there. In the description box, there is a link where I mention all the craft supply brands available in India. So you can check their stores and get some really beautiful decoupage papers and napkins and other supplies. Now here I am using my decoupage glue and I am sticking my napkin. So I will make sure that I stick this really well so that I have less wrinkles. And I'm using another flat brush to speed up my process. And this really helps me in sticking my paper so well. Now the next question was, which is the best for decoupage art, like which glue is really good for decoupage art? Now friends, the decoupage glue is something which you can make of your own. There is a Mod Podge, a huge collection of Mod Podge available in the market. Like, you have the limitations for you, like you do you want it for your glass plates, you have some different Mod Podge. Do you want it for fabric, you have some different Mod Podge. So the varieties of Mod Podges are available. Then you can even use a matte medium. So the Camel, I think the Camel brand has the acrylic matte medium. Some of the international brands also have acrylic matte medium. They are absolutely gorgeous. You just need to apply one coat and they are so good to go. And the Camel acrylic matte mediums are very easily available at any of the stores, and I'm of course sharing all the links down below for you all to buy all your supplies. I've also done a video on DIY decoupage glue, sharing the link down below. Do check that, and this is super easy to make of your own, and I'm loving this already since long I have been using this. Extra tissue paper was coming out, so I'm just trimming it off, and this is looking so beautiful. Now my next question is, what's the use of varnish? Now so many times I have been asked that why do I use varnish. Now in this project, my tissue paper has dried out and I am using varnish because I did not want my tissue paper to absorb anything. I could have used decoupage glue, but I wanted to use some nice sprays on it, so that's the reason I have taken up a varnish. Now what is the use of varnish? Varnish is a sealer which seals up your project so that even if you use any of the colors, mediums or waters or anything dust comes later on, it is just going to safely keep your project for a longer time. So yes, varnish is really, really important when it comes to sealing up your project. The varnish which I use is a water-based varnish here. Next question, can we do mixed media art with decoupage? So friends, when I see YouTube videos, when I see people sharing their projects, I always see them doing only the decoupage work, whereas I completely believe that decoupage and mixed media art, they go together so well. They are like friends. You club them together, they look beautiful, they look absolutely amazing. Like in this video here, I'm using a cheesecloth, the bandage cloth, to cover up the sides of my box. This is just going to make sure that my soft little board box becomes a little more harder, has a little more strength to it. Now here I am using my decoupage glue and sticking this, and like I said, in the mixed media you can use anything and everything. You can check my channel where I have tons of videos on how to do mixed media work. And if you see my previous projects of decoupage, I have combined decoupage and mixed media so many times, and they look absolutely beautiful and gorgeous. So like here I am using a bandage. You can use your pattern papers, you can use your cloth pieces, you can use any kind of supplies you want to have. You can even use foil papers and give a nice texture to it. You can do directly the texture work, the stencil work, and they are going to look beautiful. So when we say mixed media, it does not mean that you have to stick something on the top of it. Even playing around with the colors, your stencils or your ink pads are also going to give a really nice look and a beautiful feel to your project. So that is really important that you know that what exactly look and feel you want. Now here I'm repeating the same process on the cover, but I'm just going to have a one patch of band on the top of my decoupage tissue. Does decoupage art last long? I have been asked then so many times that does your project really last? Yes, they do last, but there is a way that you have to treat your projects. There is a way that you have to save your projects. Now, like here in this box, I'm using my modeling paste and I have taken up a stencil and I'm applying this on my complete box. So this means that I will have to seal this project at least 3 to 4 times so that my texture paste does not come out and it stays for longer time. Anyways, later on I will be doing some color work on this, so I have to make sure that it lasts long. So just keep your artworks a little more safer. Do not wash them off with the water. Of course, if you have done decoupage work on some metal project or on some plastic project or on some ceramic or even in the plastic flower pots, you might feel like having just washing them off. But give a quick wash and just clean it with a very clean cloth and you are so good to go. Of course, with the cardboard boxes, you cannot wash them. But you can always clean them with a wet wipe only if you have used your varnish really well. So here, as you have seen that I have done some of the color sprays and some color splashes. They look absolutely gorgeous. I just wanted to have more of a white shade on my box because I absolutely love white color, and in this box, this is looking beautiful. Now, as I'm done with drying, so I just took some more spray of my color, adding some more water and giving a nice border to my box. Now you will be seeing me using a cotton cloth to clean up all the excessive colors. If you want, you can use a wet wipe and blend it. It works perfectly well. So yes friends, this is how I did this video, and trust me, this looks absolutely gorgeous and beautiful, and I'm so happy that I did this, and I have tried to do all the questions whatever I could. Now at last I'm sealing my project with varnish, and here I'm going to have good 2-3 coats of varnish so that it lasts long. I hope that you all enjoyed this tutorial. If you have any queries, please do comment below. I will be more than happy to help you all friends. I have tried to answer all the questions whatever I could. Still, if you have any, please do comment below and I will be happy to help you all. Sharing few more of my DIY videos and whatever that we have discussed, the links down in the description box, do check that. Thank you so much for watching guys. Take care. Bye bye.